Right, we'll continue with what was potential difference. Now just to understand potential difference, we'll have a circuit drawn like this. This is basically an electric circuit. I'll explain in detail about the components of this circuit and how it is designed and what it actually means. But just for the time being, try to understand. Now, this is basically a cell. A cell is represented like this. This will be its positive terminal and this will be its negative terminal. Now, what happens is when we put the switch on, the electricity happens to flow from the positive to the negative terminal. So the electricity is flowing like this. It flows from positive to negative terminal. So why is this electricity flowing? Because there is an amount of potential difference between these two terminals of the cell or battery, whatever we are calling. So whenever we have an electrical source, which can be a cell, which can be an electrical source, anything, there will be a difference between the two terminals. And this is known as a cell. So potential difference, if we kind of clarify the concept, in the last slide we talked about the difference in heights of two objects, and if they are connected, this object, the difference in heights, this will cause the object to slide down. However, if the object is kept at the same height, this point A and B, the object will be at A, will remain at A until unless it is pulled by some other force. However, in this case, if there is a difference between the points A and B in their heights, then the object will tend to flow down. So this is because there is a difference in the potential. Here there is no difference in the potential energy. There is a difference in the potential energy out here. In the same way, there is a difference in the electric potentials of these two terminals of the battery, because of which the electric current is flowing. If this is at the same voltage and this is at the same voltage, the electric current will cease to flow. This will be a condition like this. So when electric current ceases to flow, the potential across the two terminals of the battery becomes the same. When it happens, then there will be no electricity that will be flowing through the circuit. Even if the switch is on, there will be no electric current that will be flowing through the circuit. So the reason why electric current flows is due to potential difference. So potential difference, basically, potential difference causes electric current to flow in a circuit. So the reason for the electric current to flow in a circuit is basically potential difference. Now we'll understand or get to the fine tunes of potential difference. So potential difference, if I have to kind of define this, so potential difference is the amount of work done in moving an unit charge. Potential difference basically is applicable to two points. Potential difference between two points, we can say between two points. Potential difference between two points is the amount of work done in moving a unit charge from one point to another. So from one point to another. So let's say the potential at point A, this is represented by VA, and the potential at point B is represented by VB. Okay, so if we have to define potential difference between VA minus VB will be amount of work done in carrying a unit positive charge from A to B. So is the amount of work done in moving a unit charge from one point to another. Potential at a point A is defined as VA, potential at a point B is defined as VB. So VA minus VB will be work done upon charge. So this is how we will define a potential difference. And this is the reason why electric current flows. So till the time there is a potential difference, current will flow through a circuit. If the potential difference ceases to exist, then there will be no charges or no current that will be flowing through the circuit. So the reason why charges move is because of the difference in potential difference. So here there is a difference between the two plates, and that's the reason why charges are moving, or that's the reason why current is flowing through the circuit. So this was about potential difference. So if we recall, 1 volt of charge, or potential difference, is defined in terms of volt. So this is volt. SI unit of potential difference is 1 volt. So 1 volt of the amount of work done when the amount of work done is 1 joule in moving 1 coulomb of charge from a point A to a point B, then the potential difference between the two points is said to be 1 volt. So if 1 joule of work is done in moving a unit charge from a point A to a point B. So, if 1 joule of work is done in moving a unit charge from a point A to a point B, then the potential difference between the two points is 1 volt. Then the potential difference between the two points is 1 volt. Now, we'll quickly finish off with the other concept of what is the instrument that is used to measure potential difference. The potential difference is measured by a voltmeter. So the voltmeter basically is represented by this in a circuit. So when we are connecting a voltmeter to a circuit, we will represent it by V. We have to be very careful here. We will never connect a voltmeter in series to a circuit. So voltmeter will never be connected like this. It will always be parallel to a circuit. So you will have to have a separate circuit like this. So in this case, it means that this voltmeter will be measuring the difference of voltage between these two points, that is A and B, which is basically the terminals of the battery. So a voltmeter has to be always connected in parallel. So it is a direct indication. So now you will say that if this electricity is flowing through this circuit, obviously will it flow through this circuit? Yes, it will. But the voltmeter is designed in such a way that it has got a very high resistance, which means that it will obstruct the flow of electricity through it. It will have a very high resistance, which will not allow the electricity to flow through it smoothly. And hence, the voltmeter has got a very high resistance. We'll understand what is resistance in the next videos and slides. But resistance is basically electrical friction. Whenever a body tries to move, in Newtonian mechanics, we have studied and we have understood that whenever a body tries to move over a surface, it encounters a friction or an obstacle to its movement. And in case of electricity, whenever charges are trying to move through a conductor, they will encounter a resistance, and depends from conductor to conductor. So in this case, the voltmeter is designed in such a way that it offers a very high resistance to the path of electricity. Hence, electricity will not flow through this and it will directly flow through this. So the circuit will remain the same. We will just connect it in voltage. But there have been questions in which it has been given to you that this is a voltmeter which is connected. Tell me if there is or tell us if there is any fault in the circuit. So the fault is that a voltmeter cannot be connected in series to the circuit. A voltmeter is always connected in parallel to a circuit. A voltmeter is always connected in parallel to a circuit. So this is something that we will have to keep in mind. So voltmeter is an instrument which is basically or primarily used to measure the potential difference. Okay, we will try and solve a couple of problems out here so that the concepts of whatever we have learned till now, that is charges and voltage, becomes a little more clearer. I will always recommend that you attempt problems in between so that you kind of are in a strong grip of the concepts. So we have till now tried to understand what is charges and what is voltage or what is potential difference. We will try and solve a certain two or three problems out here so that our concepts are very clear, so that we will be able to easily grasp the future concepts out here. Okay, so we will move on to a problem in which it is asked how much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb from a point at 118 volts to a point at 128 volts. So it has been asked here how much of work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb from a point at 118 volts to a point of 128 volts. Now we know that potential difference we all know that potential difference is equal to work done upon charge moved. So we'll just place the values out here. We know the potential difference between these two points will be how much? This will be VA minus VB. Let's say this is VA and this is VB. This will be equal to work done upon charge move. So this will be 128 minus 118, and this will be work done, which means we don't know, and the charge is 2 coulombs. So we'll just keep this as this way. So this will be 20 into 2, which means work done is equal to 40 joules. So work done will be equal to 40 joules. How much of work done in moving a charge of 2 coulombs? So work done will be 40 joules. So a pretty easy problem. We'll just move on to another problem so that our concepts are a little more clearer. So this problem states, how much energy is given to each coulomb of charge passing through a 6 volt battery. So how much of energy is given to each coulomb of charge passing through a 6 volt battery? Very clearly we see that there is a potential difference of 6 volt. When we say 6 volt battery, it means that between the terminals of the battery, the potential difference that is applicable is 6 volts. Now how much of energy is given to each coulomb? Each coulomb here means 1 coulomb. So potential difference, we all know, is work done upon charge moved. So here the charge moved is 1 coulomb. 1 coulomb, this is work done. Potential difference is 6 volt. So obviously work done will be 6 into 1, that's going to be 6 joules. So what is the charge? How much energy is given? Work done and energy are the same things. So here energy will be equal to 6 joules. So the amount of energy that is given to each coulomb of charge through a 6 volt battery while passing through a 6 volt battery would be 6 joules. So each coulomb of charge will gain an amount of 6 joules while passing through a 6 volt battery. So I hope this kind of clears your concepts about voltage. We will move on to the next important, or rather very important concept about electricity, and that is electric current itself. If you notice all these concepts, whether we are talking about charges till now, if you look into it, charges is something that we discussed. We discussed voltage or potential difference, whatever you want to call it. Both these are scalar quantities. These are not vector quantities, which means that we will just be bothered about their magnitudes and not their directions. We'll just be concerned about their magnitudes. Yes, in charges we have something called as positive charge and negative charge, so they come along with their signs. However, we will just be concerned here about magnitudes, will not be considered about directions. So this makes the study, especially in physics, we hardly encounter scalar quantities. In electricity, you have abundance of scalar quantities. So you can be rest assured that, you know, you just have to worry about the magnitude in calculations. You don't have to worry about the directions that are involved here. So all these concepts basically in electricity which we are discussing will only have scalar quantities, or we should only be concerned about the magnitudes. So this makes the calculations relatively easy from the ones which are basically involving vectors. So here we are just concerned about scalars. Now we'll move on to electric current. So what do we exactly mean by electric current? Electric current is nothing but rate of flow of charge. Now what do we mean by rate of flow of charge? So supposedly this is a conductor, and let's say we have taken an arbitrary point. Now the charges are flowing through this point. The charges are going from this way to this way. So how many charges are going through a particular point in 1 second, when the time given is 1 second? So this is like there's traffic that is going along a road and you are capturing it by a camera. So how many vehicles are passing through that same point in 1 second is going to give you the speed of the traffic. In this case, how many charges are passing through that one arbitrary point taken in a conductor in 1 second will determine the flow of current. So basically, electric current is nothing but rate of flow of charge. So it can be defined as the amount of charge flowing through a particular cross section of a conductor in 1 second. So current is basically the amount of charge flowing through a particular cross section of a conductor in 1 second. How much of charge is flowing through this conductor in 1 second, that would define the current. So again, what would be the SI unit of this? SI unit will be 1 ampere. So how do we define 1 ampere? What will be the SI? We have covered this. SI unit is 1 ampere. So what is 1 ampere? Basically current is what? Electric current is represented by I. So this is the representation. Represented by I, electric current is the amount of charge. Q is basically charge and upon T, basically time, and this would be in seconds. So we can say ampere, this is coulombs. 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb upon 1 second. So if 1 coulomb of charge, just look at this and we will be able to frame the definition of 1 ampere. If 1 coulomb of charge is passing through a cross section of a conductor in 1 second, then the amount of current flowing through it is 1 ampere. Okay, so if 1 coulomb of charge is passing through a cross section of a conductor in 1 second, then the amount of current flowing through it is 1 ampere. This would be 1 ampere. I hope you are all clear on this one. So 1 ampere is the amount of current that is flowing through a conductor, provided 1 coulomb of charge is flowing through the conductor in 1 second. So what we have here is ampere. So the SI unit of current is ampere. It is again named after the scientist Ampere, who has given quite a number of laws in electricity, which we will again start study in higher classes. Now, as we had voltmeter to measure voltage, in the same way to measure current, we will have an ammeter. So this is basically an ammeter which actually measures current. Now we will have to understand the difference of how to connect a voltmeter and how to connect an ammeter. We will have to understand this difference as to how to connect a voltmeter and how to connect an ammeter in a circuit. So let's kind of look at this. This is a circuit and this is a battery connection, again plus and minus. This is switch, and let's say we have a resistance or an electrical appliance out here. We are connecting this. So when we connect a voltmeter, as I said, the voltmeter will always be in parallel. So this is representing a voltmeter, or we can also connect the voltmeter like this out here. If we have to measure the potential difference between these two points, the entry point and the exit point. So we have to measure the potential difference between these two points so that we can understand the potential difference that is maintained across the resistor. But we have to, if we have to connect the ammeter, so we can also connect the voltmeter out here, or we can also connect the voltmeter out here. In both the cases, if we are trying to connect a voltmeter, the voltmeter will always be connected in parallel to whatever potential difference we are trying to measure. So let's say this is a point A dash and this is a point B dash in the circuit, we will connect the voltmeter as this, and we'll ensure that the resistance of voltmeter is so high that no current flows through this. So there is no amount of wastage of current when current is flowing through a conductor, because the current will not flow almost not flow through the voltmeter. So the voltmeter is going to just measure the difference in the potential between two points, which is allowing the current to flow. Now, when we are talking about ammeter, the ammeter has to be connected in series. The ammeter will always be connected in series. So ammeter, which measures current, will always be in series to a circuit. In series to a circuit. Whereas voltmeter, which measures voltage, will always be in parallel to a circuit. This will always be in parallel to a circuit. So voltmeter will always be in parallel to a circuit, whereas ammeter will always be in series to a circuit. So this is how we are going to continue with this. So we basically are clear with certain concepts about voltmeter, certain concepts about ammeter, certain concepts about current. As I said, all the things that we have studied till now, whether it is voltage, whether it is ammeter, whether it is current, or whether it is charges. So voltage, current, and charges, these are the three things that we have studied till now. All of them are scalar quantities. They do not have the backload of direction along with them. So we will just be concerned about their magnitudes. So just a quick recap about voltage. Voltage is measured in volts. It is the potential difference between two points which causes the charges to flow. Current is the rate of flow of charges. If we take a cross section of a wire, how much of charges is flowing through this in 1 second, that will give you the current. And charge is basically the electrical charge or the electrons which are there. So how many electrons, charge can also be expressed in this form. Charge is equal to N into E, which means number of electrons, and this is basically charge of one electron, which is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. So this is how we represent charges. I hope these concepts, which are very integral to the understanding of electricity chapter as a whole, are clear. Any queries that you have, just feel free to post your comments. We will continue with further more concepts into this. The very important concept that we are going to encounter in the next slides or videos will be of resistance.